Well, happy Sunday, Wayland Baptist Church. Thank God for another 7 days that He kept us. For another 7 days of His grace and His mercy. If you haven't done so, just wave at somebody and tell them happy Sunday and good morning. If my people, which are called by my name, shall humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then will I hear from heaven and forgive their sin, God said, and I will heal their land. So, oh, clap your hands, all you people. Clap your hands, all you people, and shout unto God with a voice of triumph. Hallelujah. This is revival season. Tell somebody it's revival season. I'm expecting God to do something reviving in my life. Revive us again. Our hymn of the month. Revive us again. Let's sing it jubilantly. We praise.
We praise Thee, O God, for the Son of Thy love, for Jesus who died and is now gone above. Hallelujah, Thine the glory. Revive us, we praise Thee. We praise Thee. Let me hear your voices. Who has shown us our Savior and scattered the night. Hallelujah, Thine the glory. Hallelujah, Amen. Revive. All glory. All glory and praise to the Lamb that was slain, who has borne all our sins and has cleansed every stain. Thine the glory, hallelujah. Thine the glory, revive us again. Revive us again. Fill his heart with Thy love. Make soul kindled with fire from above. Hallelujah, Thine the glory. Hallelujah.
Let's do the first verse again. We praise Thee, O God.
Oh, we praise Thee, O God, for the Son of Thy love, for Jesus who died and is now.
Woo, hallelujah.
Hallelujah, Thine the glory. Hallelujah.
Is there a hallelujah praise in the house?
Yeah, Thine the glory.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Would you just get something and put it in your hand and let's wave it as a banner of victory. Come on.
Hallelujah, Thine the glory. Hallelujah.
Let's honor Him. Let's honor Him. Hallelujah. Congregation, you sing. One more time, congregation, you sing strongly. Don't let the mass take your praise. Come on.
War.
Everyone together with great crescendo to Christ. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Thine the glory. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Thine the glory. Revive us again. Come on, give him glory. I said, give him glory. Revive us, Lord. Fill us up with the love. Hallelujah. Anybody come to worship the Father today? Anybody come to worship the Father today? Come on, some of y'all, you could have stayed home in the bed, but how many are glad you pressed your way to the house of the Lord today? Lift those hands if you will. I love you. I love you. I love you, Lord, today. Because you care for me in such a special way. That's why I praise you. I lift you up. That's why my heart, that's why I love you, I love you, oh, I love you, I love you, I love you, Lord, today, because you care for me. Let's worship. In such a spirit, that's why I praise you. Come on. And I magnify. That's why my heart is filled. My heart, my mind, my soul. My heart, my mind, my soul belongs to you. You, woo. I lift you up and I magnify your holy name. Oh, that's why my heart, my mind, my soul, break the music. My heart, my mind, my heart, my mind, my soul. Fill the house, saints, fill the house. Ooh, way back on Calvary, that's why I pray. Do you praise him? Will you lift him? And I magnify your name. Hey. Woo! That's good, worshipers. That's good. That's good. That's good. One last time before we move on. Oh, woo. That's why my heart is filled. Praise, that's why. Filled with praise. Come on, let your soul overflow. That's why how to feel. Oh, that's why my heart is filled. Softly, softly. Let's pray. We're going to the throne of grace. Come on, Reverend Briscoe. Somebody just wave that hand one more time and say, I love the Lord.
Good morning. I'm Reverend Gail Briscoe. Let us pray. Father God, we come to you this morning with praise, adoration, and reverence, God, just for who you are, We just thank you, Lord. If you never do anything else for us, Father, we just praise you for who you are, Lord. You are our creator, our sustainer, the lifter up of our heads. You are sovereign. You are righteous. You are mighty. You are true. You are merciful. You are forgiving. You are humble, loving God, Father. You never, ever leave us alone, Father. We just thank you for bringing us here yet another Communion Sunday, Father. It didn't have to be that way. It was all because of your mercy and your love that we are here today, Lord. We've been through a lot this week, Father, but you never left us alone. Father, we just thank you for being the lifter up of our heads, Father. If you never do anything else, Father, we just love you and we praise you. Father, right now on this Communion Sunday, Father, we thank you for your Son, Jesus, who loved us so much. He loved us to life by giving his life for us on the cross. He didn't have to do it. He could have called 10,000 angels, but he loved us so much that he took those sins that we bore and took it upon himself so that we could have the right to the tree of life. So, Father, right now we come with worship. We come with true worship. We come with spiritual worship. We don't come for form or fashion or to see who's here or because our name is on a program. We come because we love you, and we come because we can't do without you, and we come because we have burdens that we need to give to you, and we come because we have thanksgiving that we need to offer to you, Father. But right now, Father, we ask you to forgive us of our sins. As much as we tried, Lord, we fail in a miserable way. We've sinned against you, Lord. But we ask you now to forgive us as we partake of this Holy Communion, Lord. And we ask you to bless the sick, the shut-in, and those who have lost loved ones and who bereaved. Let them know that you are a comforter, Lord, and you're always with us. Father, we pray for the preached word. Every Sunday we get a powerful sermon, and it's not going to be any different this Sunday. But we hope and pray that someone who's either here in the building or listening by the airways will come and say, I yield, I yield. Life is not worth it without God in it. We pray that someone will come and give their heart to you, Lord Jesus. These and all other blessings we humbly thank you for and pray in the matchless name of your Son, Jesus. Amen. Amen.
Good morning. Good morning. I will be reading the scriptures today. My name is Sister Margaret Reed Jeter. We're coming out of Ezekiel 2. 3-7, and it reads as follows. Mm-hmm. And he said unto me, Son of man, I send thee to the children of Israel, to a rebellious nation that has rebelled against me. They are there, and their fathers have transgressed against me, even until the very day. For they are impudent children and stiff-hearted. I do send thee unto them, and thou shalt say unto them, Thus said the Lord God, and they, whether they will hear or whether they will forbear, for they are a rebellious house, yet shall not know that there has been a prophet among them. And there, and though a son of man be not afraid of them, neither be afraid of their words, though burrs and thorns be with thee, and thou dost dwell among scorpions, be not afraid of their words, nor be dismayed at their looks, though they be rebellious, a rebellious house. And thou shalt speak my words unto them, whether they will hear or whether they will forbear, for they are most rebellious. This is the word of God to his people. Thank you.
Put those hands together if you're glad to be in worship. Listen, tell about three people. Tell about three people. Tell them there's a blessing with my name on it. I'm going to get it. Come on, tell somebody there's a blessing with my name on it. And I'm going to receive it. Come on, clap your hands. There's a blessing with your name on it. You're going to receive it. Do not pass me by, Lord. Come on, clap your hands. We got a little time. Come on, clap, clap, clap. I see you in the back. Go ahead, get your dance on, mother. Go ahead. Praise him. Nobody knows what the Lord done. Go ahead. Wild on others, wild. Wild on others, thou art. Wild, 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 wild. Wild on others. Oh, wild. Wild on others, thou art calling. Clap your hands if you know there's a blessing with your name on it. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. You may be seated in the presence of our God. One more time before we move on, just give God the highest praise of hallelujah. Come on. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Welcome to Whalen Radio. Here's some news you can use. Watch us live each Sunday via the church website, Facebook, or YouTube. And don't forget to sign up for our group text to always stay informed. Prayer for the week. We are praying that our new converts will grow in grace and in the knowledge of our Lord and Savior Jesus the Christ. Join us online weekly for Bible study and worship service. There is something for everyone. We also have Monday night prayer service every Monday night at 7 p.m. Join us for our youth and young adult Bible study every first Saturday at 12 noon via Zoom. We will also have a meeting and Bible study on third Saturdays in person at the Whalen Village Senior Center at 12 noon. Masks are required. Midweek Praise at the Village takes place weekly on Wednesdays from 11 to 12 p.m. Join in to hear music by the SWAP Choir and a preached word by our very own Pastor Robert E. Young. Come walk with us to bring lives to Christ and pray for the release of those who are bound. Please join the Marketplace Ministry every third Saturday as we walk, pray, and connect with our community while giving God total worship through our service. Hope to see you at our next walk on October 15th. Let's get ready. We're kicking off our revival season with Healthy and Holy October. In the month of October, let's commit to exercising 3 hours each week, listening to Christian music or podcast, and fasting. Support sessions will be held each Sunday at 4 p.m. via Zoom to encourage one another and get motivated for the week ahead. Together, we are better and healthier. A new church-wide sermon and study series begins on Wednesday, October 5th, with Midweek Manna. The book, An Unexpected Revival, can be purchased at christianbook.com or on Amazon. Please note the new time for Midweek Manna is 6:30 p.m. every Wednesday. Join us for 3 nights of biblical study, spiritual growth, and development at our virtual Fall Churchwide Institute on Tuesday, October 18th through Thursday, October 20th at 6:15 p.m. nightly. Our theme is Be Well, Disciples of Christ Possessing a Sound Mind. And each session will be facilitated by Reverend Dr. Andre Ivey, pastor of the First Baptist Church of Marshall Heights. Free Maryland Food Bank Produce Drop will take place on Monday, October 24th from 11 to 1 p.m. in the church parking lot. Volunteers, please arrive at 9 a.m. Tithe and offering envelopes for 2023 will be available for pickup between 10 a.m. and 12 noon in the Fellowship Hall beginning Saturday, November 5th. Please see the flyer for additional dates. Stay connected and download the Wayland Baptist Church app on all your mobile devices. Please refer to our website for more information on these events. And don't forget to like us on Facebook and follow us on Instagram and Twitter for daily inspiration. Thank you for tuning in to Wayland Radio for your weekly announcements. Have a blessed day.
Good morning, Wayland. I'm Sister Charlene Wicks with our greetings for the morning. If we have any first-time visitors, would you stand and remain standing? Any first-time visitors today? Okay, looks like we don't. All right, this is your second or third time, we welcome you to Wayland Baptist Church. On behalf of our pastor, Reverend Dr. Robert E. Young, First Lady Misha Young, and the entire Wayland family, we say greetings and welcome again. Please consider our church family as one for you if you do not have a church home. Thank you and thank you. Please come again. As you all know, this is our first Sunday in October, so we want to celebrate our anniversaries and birthdays for this month. Would you please stand? October, anniversaries and birthdays, amen. Congratulations, well wishes for many more happy and blessed years. You may be seated. Remember, we are better together. We thank you for everything. We thank God for his blessings to us all. Have a blessed week, and we are Wayland proud. Thank you.
Just a second. You ain't getting off that easy. If this is your second or third time visiting, stand up. If you've been here two or three times, I know who you are. I'm going to point at you. Amen. If you're visiting from another church, stand up, wave your hand. That's what I thought. Okay, hey, family. All right, family, don't do that to me now. What's up, y'all? I know we're family. So let's sing to them. We got to sing to them real hard today. Come on, sing to them real hard. Come on. Say together, together, we are better. It's for church. Together we are back. Wayland Baptist Church. Welcome to Wayland Baptist Church. Together, together. Ephesians 4 Church. Together we are back. Break it down, listen. They're not here, the grandmother's here, but Brother Gerard and Sister Dana, right, they have welcomed a new baby in the house since the last time we saw. What's the new baby name? They got so many. What's the new one?
Sky. Like the sky.
We send welcome to Wayland, Sky. Amen. Amen. At Wayland Baptist Church. Welcome. One more time, let's sing together. Oh, together we are there. At Wayland Baptist Church. You may be seated. Continue to play that softly. You may be seated. Y'all, this past Wednesday, we baptized three into the body of Christ. Not only did we baptize three, we welcomed, if you will, we extended the right hand of, decision to four persons. So four persons came to Christ at the baptism. It's quiet in here. I need some noise. Somebody make. But not only that, in the midweek praise at the village, at the 11 a.m. service at the village, someone gave their life to Jesus. Amen. And I remember her because her last name is Archer, which is my son's middle name. Are you here, Sister Archer? Did you make it this morning? It's all right. Maybe you're watching this at home, but we give God praise for you. Today, we are extending the right hand of fellowship to four, amen, new, soon-to-be Waylonites. Amen. People of the way. Amen. By show of hands, how many of you have been in Waylon at least 10 years? Wave your hand. Amen. At least 20 years. At least 30 years. At least 40 years. At least 50, stand up. At least 50. That's good enough right there. Praise the Lord. Come on, we stay and we stick around. All right. Who been here 60 years? Stand up. You don't look it. You don't look it. Amen. Who's been here almost 70 years? Oh, my. Come on now, Smith. Come on now. I said 70, Sister One. Not 17. I'm going to stop right there. Let's thank God for 7 decades of witness here. The church is 115, and some folk have been here over 70 years. So today we're going to extend the right hand of fellowship to the persons. If I would just call their names so they can come on up. Together we are better. Sister Cassandra Metz. Come on, Waylon, come on. Who do I have next? Uh-oh. Y'all, let's thank God. Make some noise for our new disciples team, our ministry. Amen. Brother JT and Sister Angela Alston, amen. All the teachers who teach the new disciples, the equipping council, the AOS, it takes a village. Brother Hogan McGill. You're good. I can bring it to you if you don't want to. Come on down. Where is it? Is it all right? Okay, he on the way. Amen. Praise the Lord. Little Sister Cameron Cook, amen. Where are you, Cameron? Where are you, Cameron? She's coming. Come on down the middle aisle, honey. Come on. I just said Cameron. She can do it. Let her come on down. She got a good grandmama. I know. Let her come on down. She had a powerful testimony Wednesday. She said, I'm getting baptized today because I believe the Lord, that Jesus Christ is my Savior. He died for me. I said, you better preach, baby. Here you go. All right. Together, put them together. Organize the people. There's only two. Come on now. Amen. You good, baby. One more. Amen. Sister Winfrey Barksdale. Sister Barksdale, Winfrey Barksdale. All right. I know her vividly. I remember what she said. Amen. Wednesday. Amen. We'll make sure we get it to you. I want to make sure I shake your hand, Dad. Amen. Everybody sing together, together, together. Together. Our vision, we are a vibrant Ephesians 4 church serving in today's world. Our mission is to grow the people of the way in the 4 W's, say it with me, in the word, worship, witness, and work of the church. Our core values is stability, presence, and care. You are joining a strong assembly of baptized believers, and we say, grow with us, go with us, stay with us, and stick with us. Wow, I need all the women to make some noise for our sister right here. Come on, wow. All the sisters. I need everybody 42 and under to make some noise for her. Hey! And next year it'll be 43. God bless you. God bless you. Amen. So we say welcome. Please enjoy gifts, and we look forward to your ongoing commitment to the ministry. One more time, let's thank God for our new guests, new members. Amen. One more time, together. Together. Amen. Please bring your attention to our screen as we share in our Wailing Cares. Then we're going to get ready for the word.
Amen. Good morning to you all. What a blessing and a gift it is just to be in the presence of the Lord once again. I will bless the Lord at all times, and his praise shall continually be in my mouth. And despite of how I feel, I'm going to bless the Lord. My soul shall make a boast unto the Lord. The humble shall hear of it and be glad. Oh, magnify the Lord with me, and let's exalt his name together. Yes, God. Thank you, Jesus. Amen, God. Amen. Hallelujah, Jesus. Thank you, God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah, God. Thank you. Yes, God. Thank you. Amen. 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 Yes. Thank him. Yes. Amen, God. And for those who are visiting with us for the very first time in person or by one of our many different digital outlets, I'm Brother Brian Bowman of the Wailing Baptist Church, and on behalf of the Compassionate Carefold, I'm here to present you Wailing Cares. Each week, the Wailing Baptist Church Carefold have information reports to present to our congregation. This week's focus is God Grows You One Step at a Time, Part 2. So get rid of your old self, which made you live as you used to, the old self that was being destroyed by its deceitful desires. Your hearts, minds must be made completely new. And you must put on the new self, which is created in God's likeness and revealed itself in the true life that is upright and holy. Ephesians 4 verses 22 through 24 are the Good News Translation. Although God could transform you instantly, he has chosen to develop you slowly. Growth is often painful and scary. There's no growth without change, no change without fear of loss, and no loss without pain. Every change involves loss of some kind. People fear these losses. Even if your old ways were self-defeating, they were at least comfortable and familiar. Like a worn-out pair of shoes, you know? God habits take time to develop. Your character is the sum of your habits. You can't claim to be kind unless you're habitually kind. You can't claim to be loving unless you're a habitually loving person. Your habits define your character. There's only one way to develop these habits of Christ-like character. You must practice them, and it takes time. There are no instant habits. Paul urged Timothy in 1 Timothy 4:15 that the good word saying that practice all these things, devote your life to them so that everyone can see your progress. I hope this information has been helpful for you and will be beneficial for you throughout the week. Let's continue to be kind. Please be safe. Let us not show love with word or with speech, but with action and with truth. Let us not get complacent. We started strong, then let's stay strong so we can finish strong. Remember our three W's, washing your hands and watching a distance. If you have to be out amongst large crowds, continue to please wear your face mask. If you have not been fully vaxxed and boosted, I would encourage you to be prayerful of those efforts. And it's always be encouraged to have a Christ-centered life. Thank you for your time. See you.
Why do we give at Wayland? Why do we give at Wayland? Why do we give at Wayland? Why do we give at Wayland?
Yeah.
What type of giver does the Lord love?
Lord loves and cheerful.
Together we are better, Wayland proud. Let us pray. Our God and our Father, we thank you, O God, for all that it is that you continue to pour into us. So now, God, we come giving back just a portion that belongs to you. God, you're so good. You're so powerful. You're so merciful, Lord God. You keep on blessing us over and over again. So now, God, we pray right now, Lord God, as we feed back into, Lord God, this church and this ministry, Lord God, that it would be used for the uplifting of your kingdom, that souls would be saved, that lives would be changed, that yokes would be broken, O God, in the name of Jesus. We bless your name, we praise you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
I hope you can hear me.
Come on.
You know, we always complain about what we don't have, what we didn't get. But do you know you have so many reasons to rejoice?
Yeah.
We are not in the state of Florida. Look at all those, the devastation that happened down in the South. But God spared us. We were slept in a warm bed. Got up this morning in our right mind. Came downstairs, opened the refrigerator door, and had a choice. I can have this. And I can have that. Got up, went to the closet, opened the closet. We had a choice. I can wear this and I can wear that. Some of us got in our driveway and looked at our cars and said, I can drive this and I can drive that. But guess what? There were some saints that had to wait on a bus stop with their multi-pass, and they was thanking God because even though they had to catch the bus, was getting here because they had so many reasons to rejoice. So when you're sitting there and you're thinking about what I don't got, bad English, I know, what I don't have, think about what God has done for you. Think about what God has given to you. You have so many reasons to rejoice.
I was delivered out of darkness. But then I was delivered into the kingdom of his son.
Into the kingdom of his son.
He has given me health and strength.
Give me health and strength.
He let me see another day. A mess, but I was delivered out of darkness. And I was delivered into the kingdom of his son.
Into the kingdom of his son.
All of my sins have been forgiven.
Give me health and strength.
redeemed by his precious blood.
And redeemed by the blood.
Oh yes. Oh yes. I don't know about you, but I've got so many reasons. So many reasons. So many reasons to rejoice. On my way.
And he started me on my way.
He gave me a reasonable portion of health and strength.
Me down his way.
Then he let me see a brand new day.
And let me see another day.
Oh yes. Oh yes. Oh, thank you, Jesus. In my grave, but he woke me up this morning. And then he started me on my way.
And he started me on my way.
I have a reasonable portion of health and strength.
Gave me health.
Yes, he did. Only because of him, he let me see a brand new day.
Let me see another.
Rejoice.
So many reasons to rejoice. So many, so many, so many. I have so, so many. You have so. One more time, say, we have. We have so many. So many reasons to. Now let the words of my mouth and the meditations of my heart be acceptable in thy sight. O Lord, my strength and my redeemer. So again, Lord, don't exalt the preacher, don't exalt the pew. Preach the gospel simple, full, and free. Prove him, you'll find his promises true. I'll draw all men unto me. We come to lift you up today. Because we have so many reasons to rejoice. In Jesus' name, amen. Before I read the text, it's so good to see you in church today, Brother Julian. Be praying for you, man. Good to see you. Right there on the wall doing the work. We love you. New sermon and study series today, beginning today and for the next 8 weeks. For this fall revival season, we will be experiencing an unexpected revival, culminating with today's sermon and consecration beginning tomorrow. We will have the 4 o'clock call today. That Zoom link should be on our website tonight. Just call in and just pray with us as we prepare to consecrate ourselves before God in the month of October. We'll talk more about it. And then after the 8 weeks, we'll go into a 4 week Advent study, and we'll be nearing towards the corridor, the conclusion of 2022. Isn't God good? I must say, as a homiletician and an exegete, the book of Ezekiel is quite a challenge, and so we're going to be wrestling together for the next 8 weeks through this unique prophetic writing. It was read in the hearing earlier today, and I just read for you one verse, Ezekiel chapter 2, verse 3. He said, "Son of man, I'm sending you to the Israelites, a rebellious nation. They rebelled against me. They revolted against me even to this very day." Verse 4 said, "They're obstinate, they're stubborn." Goes on to say they're like briars and thorns, like scorpions. And I want to preach from this thought, self-destruction. The shout sermon was last week, amen. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. Look at your neighbor who's still got a lot of reasons to rejoice. Look at him. And tell him, be careful that you don't hit for self-destruction. Self-destruction is one of the most important songs in hip-hop history. KRS-One and the Stop the Violence movement of 1988. They penned a song in response to the violence in African-American communities that was an outbreak of the crack epidemic in black neighborhoods. And the verse just simply goes, you won't find this in our red hymnals, we're not going to put the words on the screen because we had to do some editing, amen. It simply says, self-destruction, you're headed for self-destruction. It was Kumo D's powerful line. He said, Kumo D said this, "Back in the 60s, our brothers and sisters were hanged. How could you gangbang?" He said, "I never ran from the Ku Klux Klan, and I shouldn't have to run from a black man. That's self-destruction." And this rap song in a prophetic tradition forewarned and foretold us about the devastation to come in the 90s that would destroy our people, that crack and crime invaded our village and pillaged us to ruins. Playgrounds became battlegrounds. And yes, there were some outside factors, but for the point and purpose of today's sermon, it was mostly self-destruction. Oh man, it's gonna be hard today, Lord. Here's a thought, don't let the rain put you to sleep. Here's a thought. Sometimes God sends us hard messages that confront us, convict us, and challenge us to change. I heard this from a doctor of mine. I said to you today that denial is not just a river in Egypt. That denial can lead to self-destruction. That one author, George Martin, stated that most men would rather deny a hard truth than face it. You cannot change what you do not confront. Some things in our life will never change if we continue to project the blame away from ourselves.
Amen.
Sister Gardner, we will continue to live in arrested development, stuck in stagnant in stupidity, if we avoid accountability for our behavior, actions, attitudes, and poor decisions. And I'll say this in love, far too often we have yielded our destiny to imaginary barriers and boundaries that only exist in our mind because of insecurity and victimization mentality. But God, that's your only shout for the next 10 minutes. I'm coming through today. Y'all wake up, come on. I might need an early organ, amen. But God, in his infinite reversalism, God can birth an unexpected revival in our lives once we admit the truth, repent of sins, and quit living the lie. That's the thesis for today, Brother Campbell. That the grace of God permits self-examination so we can avoid self-destruction.
Come on, Pastor.
That the grace of God permits self-examination so we can avoid self-destruction. Not to get ahead of myself, but when we come to the table, Apostle Paul admonished the believers before they partake to examine yourself. Because if you are preoccupied with the energy of examining yourself, I promise you won't have enough energy to examine somebody else. And that's why the psalmist said in Psalm 139, "Search me, O God, and know my heart, and try me, and know my thoughts, and see if there be any wicked way in me, and then lead me in the way of everlasting." And here it is, as I move on, over the past 2 years and 9 months, you've made too many positive adjustments. You've made too many personal improvements. You've had too many spiritual breakthroughs, Margaret, to self-destruct with only 2 months left in the year. Look at somebody and tell them, "I've come too far to self-destruct now. I'm not gonna shoot myself in the foot and I've been running the whole year." And the relevant question is, what are some signs of self-destruction? In the context, today's text, Ezekiel, really he writes about denial, despair, devastation. Ezekiel talks about despair, how it's paralyzing, and Ezekiel's name means God is strong, God strengthens. sixth century prophet Ezekiel, prophecies regarding the destruction and restoration of Jerusalem. Amen. This is pre-Ezra, pre-Nehemiah. Are you with me? And ultimately, he preached about establishing a new covenant between God and Israel. This book has a profound theological influence on post-exilic reconstruction and reorganization of Judaism. Walk with me here. This prophet Ezekiel, his ministry and visions were bizarre, erratic, and even strange. He was labeled a true psychotic. He was capable of great religious insight, but exhibited catatonia and schizophrenia withdrawal. He was paranoid. He saw supernatural visions. He saw creatures and wheels and bones coming together. And God would use this strange and strong prophet as Yahweh's spokesman to be unafraid, to be unintimidated. He was God's vocality for Israel's judgment. He judged them and he sentenced them. He said, Jerusalem and Judah, you will fall to Nebuchadnezzar. Some will be killed, some will be exiled. And according to him, he said, Judah had trusted foreign gods. Jerusalem city had fallen to injustice. He was a prophet of God. And brothers and sisters, as we're on the heels of Rosh Hashanah and the Jewish holiday, and as we go into the fall season of beginnings and revival, and as things fall off and shed, could it be that God today is still pronouncing judgment on us, that he's calling us to atonement, to remembrance, and to repentance? He's calling our nation, a slumbering nation, to receive a wake-up call, that we've had locusts, we've had pestilence, we've had pandemic, we've had political uprising, we have storms after storms after storms. Y'all ain't hear what I'm saying. And creation is groaning and moaning and travailing for the righteousness to God to stand up, that we are in a nation where guns are God. Y'all ain't hear what I'm saying. We are in a nation, oh, I wish I had more time to deal with this. Is there anybody here that knows we still have to do justice and love mercy and walk humbly before God? Just the other day, they're passing bills. Amen. Let me just move on. Just look at your neighbor and tell them, neighbor, I'm glad I'm covered from this self-destruction, because, amen, he said, if my people, which are called by my name, humble themselves and pray and seek my face. Come on, somebody, and turn. What are some signs of self-destruction? I got three and I'm out of here. If this is applicable to you, say amen or ouch. If it's applicable to your neighbor, text them about it later. The first sign that you're headed towards self-destruction is that you are unruly. Look at your neighbor just saying, ooh. They want to hoop. No, unruly. He said, Ezekiel verse 3, he said, I'm sending you to the Israelites. They are unruly. They are rebellious. They are disorderly. They are disruptive. Come on, they're out of control. They're unsubmissive. They are defiant. They resist authority. Come on. And the emphasis is on Israel's disloyalty to Yahweh. And God said, I am sending you to some insubordinate folk. From Genesis to now, come on, from the garden to now, God says they are idolatrous. They have placed other gods before me. And God said, now I'm tired of their unruly behavior. I know you're over it now, but is there somebody can keep it 100? Don't lie to your children and your grandchildren. Take that Bible off the coffee table with your lying self. How many remember you used to be unruly? Y'all don't look at me. I'll preach right through your face. Come on. Look at somebody and say, God had to do some work on me. Amen. I was unruly. I didn't follow any rule. I was rebellious. Mama said left, I say right. Mama say don't, I say do. You was the kind of person that didn't believe fire was hot, so you had to touch it. Some of you are still unruly with your robes on and come on your ties and your alligators. Y'all ain't hear what I'm saying? And since I'm done, since COVID, air rage has increased. Air rage occurs when air travelers or on an airline act violently, abusively, and disruptively towards others as they travel. And these instances since COVID have occurred in flights, and watch this, they require the pilots to divert and make an emergency landing in order to have someone taken off the flight. They have to ground the flight, cause delays to people's livelihood and travel because of unruly passengers. And isn't it, look at somebody say, that ain't right. That's not fair that unruly people delay other people's blessings, delay other people's destination. The whole thing has to be rerouted and stopped because somebody wants to have some rage. So what you're going to do after church, you're going to make sure you go through the Rolodex of your phone, go through Facebook, your DMs, go through all of your, come on, and just start deleting everybody who's been disrupting your progress, been disrupting your peace. Say, I am now disconnecting. Even if you my blood, I'll see you at Thanksgiving, but you will not disrupt the destiny and the progress I'm trying to make. This plan will not land until I get to where I'm going. Self-destruction. Headed for self-destruction because the scripture said they are unruly, Phil. Secondly, they are unlawful. They said their fathers, it's been a generational revolt. Generational revolt. This unlawful means, Reverend, not conforming to the law. Knowing the law, but not conforming to it. To push it further, it's a transgression. I mean, it goes beyond the prescribed bounds of the law. They are openly defiant against the will of God. That the people, Ezekiel says, the people were rebellious because they had revolted against the commands of God. They stretched the law for their convenience.
Come on, Pastor.
It's almost like privilege. or what's the new term that they when they diagnose spoiled children? It's called affluenza. That means you done raised them too good. Amen. They don't listen to, they spoiled right. They suffer from affluenza or entitlement. When they, like they do in America, they abuse their privilege to bend the law in their favor. So that only people who look like them can live in certain neighborhoods. Y'all ain't hear what I'm saying. They bend the law bridges, and so when crack decimated us in the 90s, it was criminalized and industrialized. But when opioids hit them in their family room, then it's hospitalized and it's sensitive. Y'all ain't hear what I'm saying. They bend it for themselves. When they hog up all the college scholarships and the grants, but then deny student loan forgiveness. Y'all hear me? When we are told to apply for jobs online, we upload documents, tedious online process, 30 applications in, fully qualified, zero callbacks. But they bend the law. They go golfing with the CEO. They buy some Oreos tickets. They bypass the process. And they put their child in a position before they even had the interview. That's unlawful. I ain't getting no help in here, y'all. And this country has slipped into self-destruction because we don't honor God's law of due justice, love mercy, walk humbly, come on, life, liberty, and the pursuit. I feel like preaching it here today. And come on, the life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness should not only apply to wealthy lawmakers, but it should apply to Lorenzo, to Julio, to Esteban, to Muhammad, to Kim. Are you hearing what I'm saying? They are thorns, they are thistles, and they are scorpions. They are unruly, unlawful. These briars and thorns and scorpions, predators, and I ain't got time to deal with that. Well, look at your neighbor, tell them, neighbor, the enemy struck me, but he didn't kill me. Come on. Come on. Are you hearing what I'm saying? I need somebody to give God a praise because you had some unlawful attacks come against your life. Come on, but like God told the devil, if you mess with Job, you can touch his stuff, but his soul belongs to me. Because he can still praise and worship me even when he's being stuck by thorns and bitten by scorpions. Matter of fact, that's why you ought to also be careful of who you sit next to in the house of worship. I ain't talking bad about nobody, but if you sit next to somebody, every time you try to lift your hands or express your exhortation to God, they looking at you with a cross-eyed thorn. They looking at you, it don't take all that. So I wish you sit down, I can't see. Well, how about you stand up and see the glory of the Lord in the place with your thorny self? Somebody say yes. I had to get that out. I wasn't trying to holler today, but that's it. They self-destruction because they are unruly, unlawful, and lastly, they are unreasonable. And Rhonda, just unreasonable. Verse 4 said, Ezekiel, these people are obstinate, stubborn, stiff-necked, hard-headed. Oh, I can't say that. You get it, right? You get it. Huh? Y'all ain't hear what I'm saying. Uncooperative, always contrary. Christians with concerns. I got a concern. I got a concern. Well, you need to see a therapist because you got a whole lot of concerns. Come on, say amen. Just unreasonable. Psychiatrists say unreasonable people twist your words and confuse you. They make subtle or overtly demeaning comments. They don't respect boundaries. They seem to enjoy stepping all over you. Bullies and emotional abusers, manipulators, liars, people who leave you feeling sad and got sickness. You feel sick in your stomach. They are crazy makers. They make you crazy. Unreasonable people provoke you to rage and then they play the victim. I got quiet on me in here. I got to sit down, y'all. That's all I have. But unreasonable, I'll say it again. Somebody just got free. I saw it lift off your shoulders. I did. I see the burden lift. So you know who you need to deal with. Come on, after church, you have your action items. Come on. The person that's always making you feel wrong and then they playing the victim, they are unreasonable and they're headed for self-destruction. Well, I got to leave, y'all. That's all I have today. That's enough. Self-destruction, they're obstinate, they're hard, they're stubborn. That's what he says. Their heart, amen, is stiff and stuck and dark. Amen. They have dismissed the will of God. I know what you're saying, Pastor. You're a hope preacher. I am. I'm a soul for sermonizer. I have to address suffering. And I have to administer hope. And I found some hope somewhere in here because he said to them, remember now. Look at your neighbor, tell them, neighbor, tell them, say, it's not over at the self-destruction. It's not over. Yeah, because remember, Ezekiel is beginning to establish a new covenant between God and his people. It won't be written on the tablets or the oracles, come on, in the holies of holies, but it's going to be written on their hearts. And in the midst of your life, whenever you have a lot of bad news, let me read this scripture for you, and I'm going to sit on down. I already hollered 10 minutes ago. Galatians 4:4 says this: but when the fullness of time has come, God sent forth his son. Bye. See y'all. That's all I got. God sent forth his son, made of a woman and made under the law, to redeem them that were under the law, that they might receive the adoption of the sons. And here it is: and because you are sons and daughters, God sent forth the spirit of a son into your hearts, where you cry, Abba, Father. And now you're no more just a servant. You are sons and daughters. You are heirs of God through Christ Jesus. That's where I need to leave y'all today. I pick it up next week. I might as well go ahead and preach like I feel it. Look at your neighbor, tell them, neighbor, I was headed for self-destruction, but then a man named Jesus pulled me out of the drug house, pulled me out of the bar, pulled me out of the juke joint, pulled me out of the clubs, pulled me out of promiscuity. That man named Jesus, who died for me, he found me just in the nick of time. That's what I come to tell y'all today. I gotta sit down. Stop it. I ain't preaching hard. But look at somebody and tell them, neighbor. That's the wrong neighbor. Look at him. Say, hey, neighbor. I don't know about you, but I was sinking deep in sin, far from the peaceful shore, very deeply stained within, sinking to rise no more. But the master, of the sea, heard my despairing cry, and from the waters he lifted me. Now safe am I. Love lifted me when nothing else could help. Love lifted me. Can I preach 3 more minutes? I know we got communion, y'all, but somebody ought to jump on your feet and say, thank you, Lord, because I didn't self-destruct. Thank you, Lord, because your grace and your mercy, 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 your mercy and your grace, your mercy and your grace, and your grace and your mercy, and your mercy and your grace, and your grace and your mercy. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. I got to sit down here, y'all. But ain't he all right? I know he's all right. Since Minister Henry, I'm an adjunct professor now at Denver Seminary, and I hope they ain't watching me today. I'm not as persnickety as I can usually am. I'm usually a little more stoic. Yeah, but look at somebody and tell them, oh, neighbor, when I think of the goodness of Jesus and all he's done for me, how he saved me from me, my soul, yeah. Because I too was unruly and rebellious. Wallace, myself, in total transparency, I too was unlawful. Halfway obedient. That's complete disobedience.
Come on, Pastor. No middle ground.
Then I too was unreasonable, stiff, stubborn. Some of you still need a good Holy Ghost icy hot. Come on, Holy Ghost Ben Gay. Some of you still stiff. But let's lift our hands. That was the prophetic word today. But as we sojourn through consecration the next month, my prayer for you was that you see the warning signs and avoid self-destruction. That you pay attention to the notifications and the warnings. That the Holy Spirit would give you supernatural discernment. So that God does not have to put you in exile to teach you a lesson. Are you receiving this today? God, help me to see what I don't want to see. Ezekiel saw strange visions and things that horrified him, but he needed to be scared straight. If it's about me, show me. If it's about my profession, show me. If it's about my family, show me. If it's how my stewardship, show me. If it's in my word, worship, witness, show me, Lord. In the next 30 days, God, show me how to end the year holy and healthy. If I have to apologize, let me apologize. If I have to admit, let me admit. If I have to come clean, let me come clean. Because I do know, Lord, that you are merciful. I know. Is there anybody here know God is merciful? How many know you serve a God of another chance and another chance and another chance? The doors of the church are open. The doors of the church are open. When nothing else could help, when nothing else could help. Love lifted me. Let's sing that chorus. Let's sing it really big. Come on, let's sing. Love lifted me. Love lifted me. Love lift. The doors of the church are open. Whoa. I know love. Yeah, buddy. Yeah, buddy. Love. Is there one? Is there one? Is there one? Come on, make a decision. Respond to the word. Respond to Christ and his church. Come on, join the church. Join the church today. Come grow with us. Lift me. In my home church, we just sing John 3:16. You know that? Sing that. John 3:16. Come on, Baptist folks, sing it. When nothing else could help. Come on, Sister Wicks. John 3. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son. Whosoever believeth on him shall not perish but have everlasting life. Is there one today? 16. I know that when nothing else, you still have time. Love lifted. Clap your hands for the word of God today. Thank God for the interpretation, the application, the exhortation of his word. Just wave your hand and say, I feel a revival in my spirit. I feel a revival. Even as we prepare now for the Lord's Supper, would you be free from the burdens of sin? There's power in the blood. Power in the blood. God, would you help me find those words? Would you? If you need a communion kit, please raise your hand. Ordained preachers, you may all go down. Amen. To the ordained, yes. Ordained ministers. There is power in the blood. There is power. Wonders working power in the blood of the Lamb. There is power. Power, wonders working power in the precious blood of the Lamb. Would you be free from the passion and pride? There's power in the blood. Power. If you can, clap your hands. Come for a cleansing. There is wonderful power in the blood. Oh yes, there's power, power, power in the blood of the Lamb. There is power, power, wonders working power in the precious blood of the Lamb. Would you be whiter, much whiter than snow? There's power in the blood.
I just want you to say a prayer over the elements for us.
Okay.
Let us pray. Lord God, we thank you for this opportunity to come to the table. We thank you, Lord God, that you said as often as we do this, we redo it in remembrance of you. That through the communion, Lord God, which was instituted on the night that you were betrayed, the blood, the wine, and the significance that they represent in the rejuvenation of our heart and our mind and our spirit for Christ's sake. Use this time of communion for your glory. For it's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Oh, in the bread. The bread, which represents the body of Christ, which is broken for us, for baptized believers, may we break and eat as they did in the upper room. The wine which represents the blood of Christ, that without the shedding of this blood, there is no remission of the sin. He shed his blood that we might be free.
Amen, amen.
May we now drink as they did in the upper room. Our church covenant. Oh, please stand as we share in our church covenant, we sin in unison. After our church covenant, we're going to give the blessing and the benediction. Were you not blessed by our worship today and to our God? Powerful, multi-sensory. The Holy Spirit visited us in a very special way today. Just give a neighbor a high elbow and tell him, he saved me from destruction. He saved me. If you only knew. Having been led as we believe by the Spirit of God to receive the Lord Jesus Christ as our Savior and on the profession of our faith, having been baptized in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Ghost. enter into the covenant with one another as one body in Christ. We engage, therefore, by the aid of the Holy Spirit, to walk together in Christian love, to strive for the advancement of this church, in the knowledge, holiness, and comfort, to promote its prosperity and spirituality, to sustain its worship ordinance, disciplines, and doctrines, to contribute cheerfully and regularly to the support of the ministry, the expenses of the church, the relief of the poor, and to spread the gospel through all nations. We also engage to maintain family and secret devotions, to religiously educate our children, to seek the salvation of our kindred and acquaintance, to walk circumspectly in the world, to be just in our dealings, faithful in our engagements, and exemplary in our deportment, to avoid all tattling, backbiting, and excessive anger, to abstain from the sale and use of intoxicating drinks as a beverage, and to be zealous in our efforts to advance the kingdom of our Savior. We further engage to watch over one another in brotherly love, to remember each other in prayer, to aid sickness and distress, to cultivate Christian sympathy and feeling and courtesy in speech. Be slow to take offense, come on, but always ready for reconciliation. And mindful of the rules of our Savior, to secure it without delay, we more engage that when we remove from this place, we will as soon as possible unite with someone of the church so we can carry out the spirit of this covenant and the principle of God's word. The Lord bless you and keep you, rather hold up, and now unto Jesus, the Christ of God, died, buried, resurrected, and coming back again. Church, say amen. Lord bless you, keep you, make his face shine upon you, gracious unto you, light of countenance round about you, give his peace. They sing a hymn and they left them out of olives. There's power. God bless you. You are dismissed. Enjoy the balance of your Sunday. Precious blood. There's power. Power. Thank you, ushers. God bless you, ushers. Watch out, ushers. Power, 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 power. Wonders work and power. In the precious, precious blood. Wonders work and power. Of the Lamb. And power, 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 power.
And claim your season to turn around. Now let's say this together, come on. Around for me,
around for me,
around for me,
around for me.